10 years ago, I made the best decision in my life. I said, I'm tired of poverty. I'm tired of depending on someone. I'm tired of asking for handouts. I am tired of walking. I'm tired of a taxi. I'm tired of up and down, not knowing if I'm going or coming back. I'm tired of seeing my mom having to ask people for this and that. I'm tired of people promising me things that don't materialize, saying they'll buy me a PlayStation or a bicycle. It doesn't come. I'm tired of just being tired. 10 years ago, at the age of 16, I was tired. And I said, I must make a decision to change my life. I must make a decision to up my life and the life of my family. If they say there has not been a millionaire before in my family, I want to be the first person. If there's something called a generational curse, or what is called a bondage, that there will not be any millionaire or a billionaire in the family, then I want to be the first. Hey, I made the decision 10 years ago. And I'm so happy that the decision that I made was able to be fruitful and materialize as I had seen it, because of the naysayers or the haters are always looking for a downfall, are always looking for a mistake so that they can say, but what were you expecting? To become a millionaire without this, without that, without this? Who are you? So I'm happy that I'm still here to tell the tale and say, you know what? It's possible to make a decision in life. It's possible just to say, you know what? It's just possible. Me, I made the decision when it was not fashionable to do so, because of, I mean, right now, if you can see a young guy like at the age of 16 and, you know, saying he's leaving school, he wants to start trading and everything. Yeah, that person, or he wants to start making money for himself. Yeah, now it's possible because of people like me, because of we were able to say, no, it's possible. We were able to make it possible so that they can dream and think those kind of things and say, no, man, I can also build a business. I can create an app. I can do this. I can innovate this. I can invent. I can, like, they can think of things ahead. But at that time, 10 years ago, I feel like even my age group at that time, my peers, hence I could not even go out and play with other kids because of I was always indoors seeing things in a different way, saying, but why in America we can find a place called the Silicon Valley, where you'll find the guys like, you know, the guys who came with this Facebooks, you know, all these things, the Twitters, all these, you know, futuristic things at that time, ahead of time. I mean, these guys were always ahead of time. In 2004, they were thinking different things that are crazy things, you know. I was like, no, man, how do they make it? But my mom gave me a wrong answer, and I think she's the one who motivated me. She said, no, these people that you are referencing, that they are young also, and they are millionaires and billionaires, and you can also make it. I think sometimes you are forgetting that you are black, they are white. I said, what? You mean the only, I thought you would tell me about the degree. I thought you would tell me that they've got a degree in financial, economic, some degree or some, I don't know, PhD. You are telling me that the only difference between me and them, financial wise, why as a family like this, we cannot become, you know, prosperous as well and it's because of they are white and black. I said, hi, now I know, let me fix this. I thought maybe you'll tell me about the PhD. That, and you know, if she said, because I was listening to her, I said, no, man, we can make it big. I can make it big. Yeah, you're still young. And I was saying these things already at the age of 14, 15. I said, no, man, I can make it big. Something, I can come up with something. Give me, you know, give me that privilege and that blessing just to say, do it, you know. But no, so who have you seen who has made it big? I said, no, look at these guys in America. The America, you're talking about rich white. I said, I thought you would tell me. And if she said that they made it because they have a PhD, I'm sure I would have pursued that PhD. But because she said it, they made it because of their weight. I said, nah, then I don't see any difference now. Let me go. Because for me, we are all human beings. I thought maybe there's an edge that they've got here. There's nothing. So, and I made it. And I made it big. Big time. Not even small. Big time. Big time. Big time. So, I made it big time. And after I made it big, I said, now watch. Because I've made it big, there are going to be people who come after me. And indeed, look what's happening right now. South Africa alone has over 300,000 traders. South Africa has over 300,000 traders. Are you hearing me? 300,000 traders. South Africa alone. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. So I think, don't be shocked soon when I start talking about retirement. You can just imagine being 10 years in the game. I started at a young age, at the age of 16. I never had a time with the youth. I never had the time to, you know, I never actually had a childhood me, actually, because even at the age of 13, 14, I was always into books and into, you know, like, you know, just thinking. I was always just thinking of ways to, you know, change society, you know, uplift people, you know, uplift the other person. How can I make life better, not only for me, but for everyone around me, beyond my family, everyone, lives must be touched. So, me, I think I deserve retirement, an early retirement. I retired, actually, by the way, when I was 21, I retired, but I was taken out of retirement. But this time when I retire, I don't want people to take me out of retirement, but don't worry, I'm not retiring soon. But don't be shocked the day when I'm saying I want to retire, because of it's too much, too much, too much, too much. You're dealing with people. Oof, guys, come on. Imagine from the age of 16, you are holding, you know, you're making it big at the 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And you are just dealing with so many people. You're dealing with so many things. And, come on. Somewhere, your mental, somewhere it's going to hit you. It's going to hit you. That is why a lot of rich people or a lot of young superstars and, you know, Hollywood stars end up, you know, doing drugs. Because if you can check, these people are not okay mentally. They're not okay. They're not okay. If I was not meditating, if I was not, you know, a prayerful person, always in meditation, I don't know, maybe I would be doing other things, because there's a pressure, big pressure. This level, the higher you go, the higher the altitude, the bigger the pressure. So, guys, let's keep up. Let's move forward. And then, if you enjoyed this video, just comment, say something, you know. Just say whatever. Give me some words of encouragement. Just to say, you know what, there are people who are still going to take over the baton. Because we are not done. I don't want to know, we are not done. 300,000. My vision was that in 10 years' time. I remember when I started, my mentor asked me, what is your vision with Forex? I said, no, my vision. The first time I was saying, no, my vision is to make a million. He says, no, I'm talking about like, what's your vision? Oh, by the way, he asked me actually, that one he asked me when I was opening my own company now, my African Forex company and everything. And he was saying to me, what is your vision with this company? I said, no, this company, I wanted to directly or indirectly impact at least 1 million traders in Africa. That was my vision. At the time, they are only maybe 10,000 traders, or maybe, I don't know, maybe less than that. But look now, there's 300K traders, and maybe it's even a mistake, that number, it's lower or higher, but we have an idea, you know, through statistics, when brokers are submitting their information. So Yeah, they say there's in 2019 there was about 190,000 traders, but it looks like it's exponentially going up now. So, guys, I think let me leave everything in your hands now. I've set the standard. I said it's possible. We can make it big, all of us. And there's so much money. It's in abundance. I don't know why traders, they're always fighting with each other. I don't know what's happening with traders. Traders on Instagram, they're fighting with each other. Facebook, they're fighting with each other. Twitter, people are, I don't know what's happening. There's trillions of dollars being offered by the market each and every single day. Yet we are fighting with each other. There's beef. People are fighting for clients. Whew. South Africa alone has a population of how much? 50 million, maybe, people. Think about it. I'm not saying Africa is huge. Africa, you go up there to Nigeria, there, up US, you go, yes, you find there are millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of people. I don't know why people are fighting for clients. They're fighting for this. And when they're fighting for clients, they're showing that they are really, they make money through education. So, not really through trading because of, why are they fighting for clients? As a matter of fact, yeah, you came, come on. Let's come on. And what's happening is that now the trading industry now, it's been, the industry is just for the intellectuals. It's not attracting the right market that I had envisaged a long time ago. It's not attracting the right market. The trading market is attracting some crazy people now. It's attracting hip-hop traders. It's attracting I call them hip-hop traders. Because they're always fighting beef. It's not attracting the people that it's supposed to attract. It's supposed to attract academics, intellectuals, people who think, with the thinking capacity, think tanks. It's supposed to attract people who can think, powerful people. But it's not attracting these people. Instead, it's just attracting people. I don't know what's happening. So, guys, please, let's save this industry. Me, now, I've made enough to say, even if I can switch off my Facebook, I can switch off my, if I can just delete my accounts on social media and everything, forget about all these things. I can always, but I'm still here. And that is, I used to ask myself a question, like, this guy is like Oprah, this billionaires and everyone. They made it big, like your Petrus Motsepe, these guys, they made it big already, but they're still continuing. Then you start to see that, no, it's beyond money now. There's a vision that they're pushing here. They're driven by vision, and they're self-compelled. They don't need motivation from the outside. So, hey, I can go on and on, say something powerful.